Hello and welcome to this exclusive session on Artificial Intelligence, course code 417 from CBSE. The sole purpose of this session is to give you an understanding, give you an insight on the basic fundamentals of Artificial Intelligence, why this course has been introduced by CBSE, what all benefits are there for students in pursuing this course. Let us first of all develop our basic understanding about Artificial Intelligence. Putting this term artificial intelligence in simple terms, you can think of a thinking machine, a machine which is capable of thinking just like we humans do, a machine which is capable of learning from what it does. Basically what computers do, computers process some data and give us some output. Now out of this process of processing the data, if computer is able to learn from it, and then it adds that learning to its experience so that it can put that learning to use in future in different scenarios. Now, this is something called artificial intelligence. So, in artificial intelligence, actually, they are trying to put human intelligence into the machines. How do we humans learn? Since birth, we humans take inputs from in the form of various stimuli from our sensory organs, and then we respond accordingly, we observe, we learn from others, we learn from our mistakes, and then as we grow, we use that learning to move further in life. Now if we compare this to a computer, a machine, of course if you want a machine to learn something, to develop some skills, let's say, for example to play chess, or to drive a car, or to analyze a data set to do some predictions, or to analyze an image for some purpose, or to create a summary of a video, or to create a summary of a textbook, or to identify the speech, what has been spoken. These are certain examples. If we want a computer or a machine to do all this, how are we going to train that machine? How are we going to make that machine learn so that it is able to do that? And the answer is data. A lot of data. In past 3-4 decades, since the advent of computers and especially internet, earlier we didn't have that much data around. But now today, when billions of transactions have been happening as we speak online, many transactions are happening at the moment, and this has been happening in past 3 decades. So if we look across these three decades, innumerous and enormous amount of data has been around on social websites, on various commercial portals, on learning portals, on entertainment portals. So this entire huge data can be used to make that machine, make a particular machine learn from it. This enormous chunk of data, this huge enormous amount of data which is dynamically adding up also, is generally called as big data. Now this big complex structure of data that can be taken out and can be fed into a machine which is running on an artificial intelligence algorithm, and that artificial intelligence algorithm can be trained into predicting, into doing some predictions, looking into the patterns out of the data set which has been fed into it. So processing enormous amount of data is one aspect of artificial intelligence, one domain of artificial intelligence. If you look at another aspect, data is not in its only simplest form. Data does not mean some text or some number or a date of joining or a text of or a series of characters. If you look around in real life, data has its complex forms also, like a video clip or an audio clip, a piece of news being read by the news reader, satellite imagery, a photograph maybe. So all these are the complex forms of data, and if an AI algorithm is made to learn to analyze these images to meet some purpose, for a particular purpose, for example, analyzing the satellite imagery to see some patterns in it, then this capability of AI is called computer vision. So the complex forms of data, audio, video, images. These all fall under the domain of computer vision, where AI algorithm is capable to analyze these complex forms. Now, another form of data is in terms of the human language, what we speak, what has been spoken. So speech recognition is another aspect where an AI algorithm can help a lot. And AI, you might have seen Alexa and other such interactive voice response systems, which are capable of understanding, figuring out what has been spoken, and accordingly they respond. There are chatbots also, which are capable to understand what question has been asked by the customer. So this all is called speech recognition. Another advanced form of this is voice recognition, where an AI algorithm is capable to figure out who has spoken. This particular sentence has been spoken by David or by you. So when this capability comes into AI features, then it is called voice recognition. So speech recognition, what has been spoken, voice recognition, who has spoken. These fall under the third domain of AI, that is called natural language processing. So first being data, second computer vision, and the third is natural language processing. On these three pillars, the entire AI concept has been built, is based on it. And this is what the course from CBSE in class 8 is talking about. CBSE has introduced in class 8 the very fundamentals of artificial intelligence. It has not been kicked off as a full-fledged course. This is a certification course for class 8 where students can go through it and they can decide further whether they want to take it up in class 9th and in higher classes as a serious course to study. Besides all this, CBSE has also incorporated the applications of AI. We look into various areas where this artificial intelligence can be incorporated in various industries, in various verticals of industries. Think of a smart city where entire smart city is equipped with AI-based gadgets and algorithms which are controlling the city, which are providing value-added services to the people and which are sustainable. That means they are beneficial for society, they are beneficial for economy, and at the same time, they are not harming the environment. They are not creating any threat to the future generations. So they are sustainable. So that's one very very interesting aspect of this course, is that it is talking about how artificial intelligence can help us in achieving the global 17 sustainable goals, which have been incorporated, which have been recommended by UNO, and India is one of the members, and how AI concepts can help in addressing these social issues. So this also has been incorporated as the part of this course in class 8. A class 8 course is also talking about various career aspects pertaining to artificial intelligence in various industries. What all benefits are there out there in the form of career and jobs for the students. So this all has been discussed in detail in class 8. Moving on to class 9th artificial intelligence course from CBSE. In continuation to class 8, this course is talking about artificial intelligence project cycle. It is going into the details of how AI can be introduced into various aspects, various operations of a company or an industry. So this project cycle has been divided into various steps. For example, problem scoping, then data acquisition, collecting the data and moderating the data for AI algorithm. Data exploration, deciding which data is suitable to be fed into AI algorithm for training purpose and which data needs to be discarded. All those aspects are discussed with this. Then data modeling, how various patterns can be generated out of the collected data and how that training happens. And finally, the final step, selection of the best suited AI algorithm depending on the best training done by the data collected. So this all entire process of AI project cycle has been discussed in class 9th. Moving further in class 9th, the very basics of Python programming language are given, because Python is the most accepted language in industry for AI programming. So the very basic fundamentals, what all Python is about, what are the features of Python, what are the basic programming structures in Python, and one very powerful Python data structure, that is list, is also discussed in class 9th course. So this is a very brief glimpse of the basics of artificial intelligence course 417 from CBSE in class 8th and class 9th. Now coming on to the course structure and why the book from Edusoft is most suited for the schools to take up this course, for the teachers to teach and for the students to go through. The reason being that this book is completely mapped onto the guidelines recommended by CBSE. CBSE has introduced a teacher's manual for all the teachers who are going to conduct the course for AI. On that very manual, the book from Edusoft has been mapped on. Teachers will find themselves at home while conducting this course, because they will be going through the teacher's manual, which has been given by CBSE. And then when they look at our book, they can simply map that manual with the book, and they can easily understand and prepare the sessions in the classes. Second strength of the book is that it is completely activity based. So teachers are recommended to conduct those activities in the classrooms, in the labs, and then they debrief after the activities and then use the book as a reference material to explain the concept to their students. So this way, the things will come easier to the students. They will be involved in the course, their interest will be engaged in the course, and it will be easier for the teachers also to conduct the course in a very interesting and very effective manner. And this is one thing. Then course is also focusing on the practical aspects of the concepts. It's not that since fundamentals are being taught, so it's all theory. Exposure has been given in the form of online web services where students can go and really experience that artificial intelligence thing happening actually in real life. Google experiments and various other projects which are running online, the introduction of those things has also been given to the students there in the course. Then students are given experiential learning modules where they have to go along a URL, they have to explore the information online, and then they collect the information and analyze it and present it in one form or another. So that will give them an exposure and experience of going through the real life scenarios and developing their analytical and critical thinking skills. If they are working in groups, that will also help them develop their leadership skills and their interpersonal skills. So course is focusing on these life skills, the technical skills, and the basic conceptual skills also. So in this regard, the book completely stands out if you compare it with other books. Third very strong aspect of this book is that it is filled with so many real life examples that whatever has been discussed as theory in the course, that is supported by some real life example. So it's not that just a talk is happening. Students get to know how this particular concept is being used or incorporated in real life. There is information search project given for the students, where students can go online and they search the information themselves. Here the responsibility of learning goes on the shoulders of students. They go for self-paced learning and then they get back to the teacher, they discuss the things what they have learned. This also develops their interpersonal skills, their analytical and critical thinking skills. Then the project given in the book is completely practical oriented, where they will go online and they will try to train a computer. They will prepare some data, upload that data, the machine will be trained, and then they will test it, how that machine has been trained well. So this all is incorporated in the book. So this is what this book from Edusoft is talking about. And if you go through the book, of course you will decide the book on its merit. But when you go through the book and compare it with the recommendations from CBSE, the teacher's manual, we are sure, we believe that this book on artificial intelligence will be your first and of course the very right choice. Thank you so much for listening.